All right, welcome back to another Honcast.com presentation. I'm Breaky CPK. Once again, going to be a shoutcasting host. And joining me this time, a couple of new guests. We got Brent Quest of Clan QS, okay, of the Honcast staff, as well as special guest, Competitive Insight, Cardinal from SK Gaming, the SK Gaming that we just saw have a solid performance against DRD right there. I'm sure he's excited about that one and looking forward to moving on. But possible opponents in the near future for SK Gaming could be one of these two teams. With that said, this is the Gosu Gamers World Cup, the main event. Again, another quarterfinals matchup, arguably the most anticipated one. Looking ahead to the week, we got Online Kingdom, formerly known as KD Gaming, going up against KD Gaming, now formerly known as Dirty Minds. So again, it is a little bit funny there, the whole sequence that one team following after the other. But yeah, you can definitely tell by the player names who's who, and should be a very, very good best out of three series here tonight. Looking forward to having it happen. With that said, though, like I said, I'm joined by Brent Quest. First, how you doing, Brent?
I'm great. Been a good day of casting so far. A lot of exciting games from this Gosu Gamers tournament. Been so impressed with how it's been going so far and getting down to the semifinals, quarterfinals. Going to be really exciting.
Yeah, it's definitely it really is. I mean, there's, like I said before, I mean, this tournament has so much in it, so many great teams. We've seen a lot of teams kind of come up out of nowhere, especially a lot of these teams from Brazil, or even Southeast Asia, even a South African team. I mean, teams are just popping up all over the place. International tournament's been a great event, but like I keep referring to, we're getting down to the nitty-gritty, the top tier elite teams, and these two teams definitely qualify for that. So it's been a lot of fun so far. Looking forward to getting down to the eventual $10,000 first place prize, $40,000 overall split between all the teams. Cardinal, you're also joining us. Going to be making some of that change there. How you doing, Cardinal?
Doing good. Just excited to watch this matchup. Possibly see both these teams later on in the future in upcoming tournaments.
Yeah, like I was talking about earlier, I believe you guys are on the other side of the bracket, of the winner's bracket, but if you do happen to get to the finals, you know, you possibly will meet up with one of these two teams, or somewhere in the loser's bracket, or just other events in general. But, of course, you guys are up there with the elite of the elite. But this matchup here, Online Kingdom versus KD Gaming, I just cannot stress it enough. It's just such an awesome matchup to have here. We do see an interesting thing to point out right away. Kabop is actually playing for Online Kingdom. He did recently announce that he was going back to Dota to play for a very solid competitive team over there. However, he is playing here, and this is actually, although a replay cast, these matches happened earlier today. So just today, he is back playing with Online Kingdom. So that is good news. I mean, Kabop, definitely, I'm a fan favorite of him. I do appreciate his skills and an awesome all-around player. As holy crap, I forgot to actually start the broadcast, so let me do that real quickly. There we go. Now that we're actually started, okay. Wow, that's kind of funny. Whatever. All that will be on VOD. But okay, I apologize, streamers. Those of you that are tuning in. We already did the introductions and everything. I actually forgot to set it to actually live, but it is coming up live. But if you really want to hear the introductions, you can go watch the VOD after. No, but real quick recap. I am a Breaky CPK, joined by Brent Quest of the Honcast staff, as well as Cardinal from SK Gaming. This is Online Kingdom versus KD Gaming, best out of three, game one here. Looking forward to it. So let's just jump into the bans, though. Let's get over those. As far as the bans are concerned, we are looking at Forsaken Archer, Chipper, Voodoo Jester, Behemoth, Devour, and Pharaoh. A couple of interesting bans. Obviously, the standout one for me, at least, is being that Behemoth ban over there. Not too often we see Behemoth banned. In this case, though, banned by KD Gaming. I was just talking about, you know, Kabop being back here for Online Kingdom. He is now playing, although, you know, recently announcing that he was going back to Dota professionally, but he's still playing for Online Kingdom here. A very good Behemoth player, perhaps a reason for that ban. But overall, what do you think about these bans here, Brent?
Very interesting. Some new, some old. Behemoth, one of those heroes, is really pesky, as we saw the other day. Really a push stopper and really helps Turtle, so if you don't want to go up against something like that, it's a good idea to ban him. Chipper as well has been picked up a lot more lately. That buff to his ultimate as well as, so really got some of his pop back to deal a lot of damage to heroes right away, and the focus buffer is also very efficient.
Oh, yeah. Chipper has been a hero that we've been seeing a lot more lately, like you said, because that, not necessarily 100% because of that buff, but that change to the oil definitely made the combination of the rockets and the oil a lot more effective. And he always has been a very sound hero, but more so now because of perhaps of that change. But Cardinal, curious to see, what do you think about these bans as we are getting into the game here?
I mean, I agree with most of the bans. I'm not sure about Chipper, unless they're banning for a particular player. But for the most part, pretty standard bans. Behemoth is definitely something that can set up tri-lanes. So I'm guessing that's why Kitty banned Behemoth, because, you know, it's a really good tri-lane hero to set up a stun and a couple kills on heroes. So pretty standard, though.
Yeah, pretty standard. Obviously, though, again, the Behemoth, a little bit standout, but nothing really too wondering there. We are loading into the game now, so want to do a sync up real quickly to make sure that we're all kind of on the same track. All right, I'm going to go by the in-game counter. It's counting down, of course, so we're looking at 119, 118, 17, 16, 15. You're far behind. Try to catch up if you can.
What do you have a speed at, 2 or 1?
No, just 1.
Yeah, I don't know why I'm so far behind. Let me catch up real quick.
All right, yeah.
So what's the counter at?
Here, you know, I'll go ahead and pause it at 8:40 on the replay counter. We'll just do a sync up from there.
Okay, I'm almost there.
I'm good.
Do-do-do.
Okay, good.
All right, do another countdown. Let's go. 3, 2, 1, go. 41, 42, 43. Should be good. All right. Okay. So, now that we're in the game, got the sync taken care of. All right, so went over the bans. Of course, next step in line, let's look at the picks for Online Kingdom. Again, I know we were talking about this earlier. It is kind of funny, you know, seeing these two teams, how KD Gaming, formerly known as Dirty Minds, it's the old KD Gaming versus the new KD Gaming, technically. So, yeah. Anyways, as far as the Legion team is concerned, as people are complaining about the stream, they just need to reload it. It's working fine on my end, and everything looks fine on my end, so they just need to refresh it, and it should be good. Anyways, so for the Legion team, we got Malakin, Slither, Andromeda, Witchslayer, and Soulstealer. You look at the 5-man roster over there for Online Kingdom. Interesting lineup. They're going with the Malakin tri-lane. Again, this obviously made famous from Fnatic MSI, as they do with a lot of these strength carry tri-lanes. We got Soulstealer playing the mid, and then it's going to leave Slither to play top. Not too often we see Slither play solo, but again, going back to Fnatic MSI, that's what I recall lately, is Trixie has been doing that, has done that a little bit at least, and definitely has been successful with it. Always interesting, though, to see some newer heroes playing at some odd spots. We do have a vote to pause here to start the game, but I'll give us some time to talk about this. Legion side, how are you liking the Legion build over here, Malik, or Prent?
Oh, it's pretty solid all around. Once again, we see that Slither being solo. I mean, I was kind of doubtful at first, but when we saw him really take off and get those levels, the toxicity as well as his ultimate and spamming those wards is so much damage. It's really underrated, I think, at the moment. And we got that, I mean, obviously Black, amazing solo mid, Soulstealer play. I've been really impressed with him lately in the games. And very MSI-esque tri-lane bottom with the Malakin carry. So it's interesting to see how they'll do with that.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and restart the stream, because it's just nonstop spam in IRC right now. So I'm going to go ahead and restart it and see if that fixes it. So we'll be right back.
Good.
All right, so we should be good now. Restarted it, because a lot of people complaining. So it should be good. If it's not, then honestly, I have no clue. We'll just hope for the best. Okay. So, as we were talking about, Online Kingdoms lineup here on the Legion side. We already went over it. Brenna gave his opinions on that. So now, Cardinal, what are your thoughts on Online Kingdoms lineup, as they make an adjustment right away, actually?
Yeah, they were going to send Solo Slither top, but then I think what they did was they saw a dual lane mid, so they figured they're going to dual lane top. So Slither looks like he's just jungling now, and they're just going to leave top lane to free farm. But I like the Malakin reforming bottom against the solo Hellbringer. It seems like a good setup. It's going to be interesting. The dual lane, I think, is going to be in mid, is going to be the game changer early game at least. See if they can kill Soulstealer early.
Yeah, clearly being able to take out Soulstealer early on is obviously a very beneficial thing to have, or, you know, just keep him locked down at that. And that's, you know, being 2 versus 1, you would like to think that they could be very successful at that. But with that said, by the way, we have actually at the bottom lane Poison Spray coming out of the Hellbringer. Malakin with the auto attacks, and that's going to be your Bloodlust kill, actually. Well played by the Legion side right there. Malakin in the end, though, he ends up going down to the tower attacking him, so a little bit of a back and forth there. Or the dot, excuse me, was also helped take him down. So what looked like to be a Bloodlust kill and then get out of there, unfortunately ended up turning around. But he did get the Bloodlust kill, at least. The point that you were referring to, though, with the Soulstealer, he is being played by Black, however. In Black, we have seen some very impressive Soulstealer performances from him lately. And he is quickly making a strong name for himself in the Heroes of New Earth competitive community. And so it's going to be interesting to see how he fares against this 1v2 matchup. But with Bubbles, with the Haste and Pebbles in there, it's of course is going to be very, very tough. He is managing, though, a 6-3 creep score start, so honestly not doing too shabby. He is maxing out Demon Hands first, as you would expect, so that he can throw those nukes in there, allowing him to get those creep kills. Malakin, by the way, after getting that Bloodlust kill at the bottom, has teleported to the top lane, and as a result, we are having that 3-2. The Toxicity debuff ticking on Hellbringer in the bottom lane in the meantime, and going to harass him a little bit as he falls all the way back. So the quick early adjustment here from Online Kingdom has, you know, definitely caused some confusion perhaps on the part of KD Gaming, and now we're kind of seeing that 3-2 matchup, and this is going to almost force KD Gaming to make an adjustment themselves. So a lot of movement here early on in this game. Let's go over KD Gaming's lineup, though, before we have action picking up here. For KD Gaming, as we do, as I just saw talk about that, we got middle initiation. Oh, Pebbles needs to be careful. Lucky Soulstealer decides not to try some Demon Hands right there. Could have very likely nuked him down. But so KD Gaming's lineup, we got Pebbles, Hellbringer, Magmus, Bubbles, and Flint Beastwood. Very, very aggressive team. We got the Pebbles combination, and then Magmus also for the assistance as well, and this great, great Lava Surge ability. Flint Beastwood, definitely known as one of the more active carry-style heroes. All around, you know, a sound team. Going to be interesting, though, to see how they match up. Arguably a lesser strengthened late-game team than OK or Online Kingdom. But, Brent, what are your comments to make on this Hellborn side over here? As we do have action at the bottom lane real quickly. Slither's going to get initiated on, and Hellbringer and Magmus combo him down. So they actually take the 2-1 hero kill advantage with that. But, Brent Quest, thoughts on the KD Gaming over here?
The first thing I notice is definitely the team fight potential they have. I think they're really going to have an advantage in an overall initiation and AoE and the whole package there. As far as team fighting goes, I think it's really going to come down to the Hellborn team being able to initiate and take out some of those carries and supports. As far as lanes go, this middle lane's really been confusing for me. I mean, I understand wanting to keep Black down, but Pebbles and Bubbles are two heroes you definitely want to get those levels on. And I guess they're doing a pretty good job so far, but Black is definitely hanging in there.
Yeah, you know, exactly.
Magmus is roaming.
That's the other thing that's kind of throwing me off, too. Magnus, as you just said, he's roaming. He's been spending a lot of time in this middle lane and yet to come up with any type of kill. While that is going on, of course, Flint Beastwood, he's going 1-3 right now. So his farm is of course, drastically, you know, being hurt because of that. Although he's managed a 14-4 creep score, perhaps from earlier on, because right now you see him pretty much hugging the tower, playing very, very defensive. So, yes, right now it is kind of forcing Black to play very defensive because of the setup that KD Gaming is running with pretty much three in the middle at this point. But, you know, you're kind of hurting the rest of the situation. So it's going to be curious to see how this turns out and how this really ends up playing out for them. And whether or not, you know, they once again adjust. But expecting a lot of movement here early on, and we are definitely seeing that. Cardinal, though, I'm curious, what are your thoughts on what KD Gaming is doing here? They pretty much are running a tri-lane middle, it almost looks like.
Yeah, it definitely looks like they know Black's a really good player, and I don't know if I like the Pebbles-Bubbles dual lane mid, because you're really relying, Pebbles getting close to position on Soul Stealer to even set up a kill. But I like how Magmus is roaming, and they're really keeping him down early.
Speaking of that, Magmus is here at the bottom lane now, but still they're going to throw out some wards, as well as spotting him coming initially from the ward of sight down there. He's going to be fine. Bubbles coming in from behind on Andromeda here at the top side, but not going to actually open. Well, there he goes. He actually sent the illusions forward. He runs right into Malekan, though. He might be in some trouble right here. Sword throw from Malekan, blocking him in as Andromeda, and Bubbles in a lot of trouble. Flimpiece comes in, trying to put in enough auto attacks to scare off Malekan at least. Can he get the last hit? No, he cannot, and a great turnaround for KD Gaming. Wow, Bubbles thanking his teammates right now. He was very, probably should have been dead right there if it was Era, but in the end, somehow managing to get away, thanks to Flint Beastwood, and then eventually Magmus coming in with a great Lava Surge stun. So, again, we already are seeing a lot of movement from both teams, more so perhaps KD Gaming, as Bubbles is now recovering, perhaps surprised to himself that he is still alive. So he's going to roam back to the base. But the point you were touching on earlier, Brent, is, you know, the lack of levels on both Bubbles and Pebbles as a result of them kind of laning together, it's kind of showing right now. So they're already level 7. You see Pebbles, he's pretty much at the same place, but at level 5. So really hurting that point, and definitely a hero that really relies on that early on to, you know, be a force to reckon with. And unfortunately for KD Gaming, they're not going to be able to take benefit of that. So we'll see how that plays out. Black doing a good job once again, though, of constantly going back and forth between the jungle and the lane. Whenever the lane's pushed up, he goes there to nuke it down. Whenever it's pushed back, he goes back to this at least this yellow creep stack and nukes it down. So he's keeping a solid farm. Honestly, 271 gold per minute for Soul Stealer carry, who's been 1v2, if not 1v3, for a lot of this game so far, is really an awesome job for him, and that's very good news for Online Kingdom.
Hey, real quick, I crashed. What minute mark are you at?
Okay. In game, I am at... Actually, I'll go to the replay counter. Replay counter, I'm at 18 minutes, 18:01, 02, 03, 04.
All right.
It's good in that area.
Alright, I'm at 18:03.
I got 18:21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Try to catch up the best you can.
Alright, good.
18:30, 31, 32, 33. Sounds like just maybe a couple seconds behind. Okay.
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, good to go now. Alright. Well, yeah, but, you know, as let me drag that out real quickly. There we go. Okay. Possible gank, by the way, at the top lane. Andromeda is pinging on top of him. Middle lane is actually going on as well. Hellbringer gets the ultimate off, and Soul Stealer is going to be going down. So KD Gaming, noticing that Black is getting a very powerful farm, wanting to slow him down, and it took a Hellbringer ultimate to assist it, but hell, at least they got the kill on him. Now everyone pointing to the top lane as the initiation happened on a Flint Beast with the ultimate from Malekan activated. He's going to get the kill on him. And now Andromeda, however, might be trapped right here. She's going to eventually fall down. Malekan needs to get away now. Not enough mana for a sword throw. Needs 130. He gets enough mana now, but not going to be in time. He gets taken out. Good stalagmites from Pebbles. Witch Slayer also going to caught, completely missing a graveyard stun. And he's going to drop in the process. Wasting on Hellbringer. Ends up with a double tap through all of that. And, well, technically three kills, as he also got the kill on Black in the middle lane. So Hellbringer making his presence felt all of a sudden. He came from the bottom lane down there, doing a solid job against Slither so far, being level 8. As the courier gets taken out, that's unfortunate, in favor of Online Kingdom. But yeah, so Hellbringer making his presence felt, doing a good job of roaming around, and sets up in total three kills, including on Soul Stealer.
Yeah, great movement overall from the Hellborn team so far. I was going to say, the Hellbringer is about the only lane that they've won so far, and he really needs to get moving with that ultimate right away. They come gank Black in the mid lane. Magnus also doing a good job roaming around. He's a really underrated roaming hero, I think. As we saw in one of the games the other day with OK, I believe it was Overpow roaming around and really helping out Black in the middle lane get some ganks. And he can be definitely scary to see him coming in with that very powerful stun.
Oh yeah, no doubt Lava Surge is one of the more powerful ganking tools and just all around more effective tools in the game to use. I mean, it's great for team fights as well, of course, and Just has a lot of purposes. Pebble's going to run into Slither here at the bottom lane. He throws off the combo. One more auto attack. There we go. And, well, Pebble is being played by a low QOP, doing what he does best, moving around and starting to get some kills. So despite, you know, being two, even three players in the same lane at a time, kind of nerfing his experience. Oh, he might get Soul Shooter right here. Yes, he will. Great job by Pebbles. Using the haste rune to full effectiveness. Kept it going after the kill on Slither in the bottom, figuring that Soul Shooter is probably somewhere around here in the jungle. He was correct. And gets the kill on him as well. So Pebbles, you know, just with those two kills alone, really already accomplishing quite a bit early on here for KD Gaming. And Online Kingdom, you know, off to a great start themselves. But Black, he's still sticking around the same mark, so hasn't been progressing, not falling down at least, though. And more positive things definitely shining here for KD. The one big thing, though, is actually at the top lane here on Hellbringer. Malakut using the ultimate, the sword throw on top of the Hellbringer. Gets the ultimate off, actually. So at least that's good. But will it be enough to make a turnaround here, perhaps? Magnus is standing in there. Oh, he's taking a lot of damage himself, though. He's going to go down, but Malakut eventually fell to Wasing from Malphus. And I believe he had a dot on him as well, and now Malph is still chasing, has a flame breath, gonna use it right there, getting a little bit of a hit on Witch Slayer, but not enough for a kill. At least he's gonna force him now to use some regen, it looks like, which he still had on him. But yeah, Online Kingdom, or excuse me, KD Gaming, this is so confusing, KD Gaming, they are not in the most horrible spot. I mean, early on, again, it was very questionable with their lanes and whatnot, but looking a little bit better now. And of course it starts with this Pebbles, but Hellbringer also a nice addition. But the scariest thing right now for KD Gaming at this point, I got to figure, is the farm on Flint Beastwood. It is progressing, but still struggling a little bit.
Definitely. They're definitely picking up pressure now. Pebbles got a couple of kills there and shot his level up. Now he's level 10. He's going to be a huge factor in this game. He's up to about 1,500 gold, so probably hoping to get that portal key very soon.
So
farm goes, Flint is, oh yeah, I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
He's starting to increase a little bit. I mean, his team's definitely on the move, going to be pushing some towers down, hopefully pick it up there. While at the same time trying to keep Malkin and Black's farms to a minimum.
Yeah, it's that's a very good point right there. I mean, for KD Gaming, it's right now perhaps need to be more worried about slowing down Malakut and Soulstealer than they should be worried about getting that farm on Flint Beastwood at this point. Cardinal, as we are going to this pause here, Cardinal, I mean, is there anything in the to you that's necessarily standing out here that you want to feel like pointing out?
Yeah, this Pebbles is playing really well. The thing about Soulstealer is when you're Pebbles and you don't see him on the map, the only place you really want to scan your mini-map first and see where, if there's anything on the map. And the first thing you go to is the jungle, and that's normally where he would be killing the doubles and triple stacks. And this Pebbles went right to the jungle after he got the kill bottom on Slither and picked off Soulstealer, so he's been doing a really good job.
Wow, Magnus gets away right there. Malakut chose to use a homecoming stone rather than get the last auto attack off on Magnus. As a result, Magnus survives, and wow, Hellbringer coming in at the right time, I guess. Once again, it seems like he's been there at every single or a lot of these strong points to be in there. Oh, Soulstealer might be in some trouble. Trying to destroy the money shot with the swab. Not going to happen, though. Now Andromeda trying to run away, but Pebbles going to get turned around on, and Pebbles will go down. That ended up being a very good swap in the end by Andromeda. Yes, she did get taken out, but if it wasn't for that swap, the combination from Pebbles would have also landed on Soulstealer there and perhaps been enough for the kill. So very good save right there by Kebop playing that Andromeda, and Black, I'm sure, happy with that he's able to survive through all of that. So, yeah, I mean, pretty much going back to your point, though, it's you got to scan that map and keep an eye out where, Soulstealer is at all times, as you know, vice versa as well for the Legion team. Have to look out for that Pebbles and make sure they know where he is, so where he's coming from. And right there just happened to be good timing on the part of Online Kingdom. So Black right now, he is hitting that 300 gold per minute mark. You can already take a look at his farm as a result of that. Steam Boots bottle and also picking up a Mighty Blade. Very likely going to be going for the Shrunken Head, especially against this Pebbles right here. So what are your thoughts, Cardinal, on we kind of had this discussion in a recent cast, but going for that early portal key on Soulstealer, do you think it's necessarily a smart move maybe in this game or other games, or are you just a fan of going something else?
It really depends on the matchup and what type of team support you have. I mean, if you have like a Behemoth or like a Pebbles or a Magmus on your team, then it's good to get it first because he's the one that's going to be initiating on. But on a team like they have, really the only person they have to initiate besides Andromeda, which isn't really, you know, in my opinion, a good initiate, is Malakin. And I don't know, I don't agree with it in this matchup, but it definitely can work. But I think he's going to go straight BKB or Shrunken Head. That's the best choice.
Yeah, while that's going on, though, we have now action at the bottom lane. Look at this movement here from KD Gaming. Go right from the top lane after the gank on Malakin to moving down to the bottom lane and gank Slither. Magmus, though, well, he's going to live because that ultimate cannot tick him down, of course. So he barely gets away right there, but back and forth right there from KD Gaming, first at the top, then at the bottom, setting up a couple of solid kills, and KD Gaming up 14-6 now in hero kills. They're taking benefit of this very aggressive early game team, and they've really been accomplishing that. And on top of that, honestly, this Hellbringer he's been doing a very good job of using his ultimate to be a very good ganker with it. I mean, obviously, usually we see a lot of Hellbringers save it for pure teamfight situations, maybe on two or three players at the very least. Never really see it on a solo hero, but we've seen it a couple times now being used on a solo hero. Both times, I believe, on Malakin, and it sure enough helps set up the kill onto Malakin. Andromeda, in the meantime, also gets picked off. So, Online Kingdom, this is, again, they were off to a very good start in terms of farm, at least. But KD Gaming, this is where they're starting to shine because of their makeup. And as far as I'm concerned, KD Gaming, you know, you can argue that they have an advantage at this point as Flint Beastwood's farm continues to grow. Pebbles wants to go on block right here on Soul Studio. He lands a Stalagmus. He's going to chuck him backwards. No, he chucks him straight up, but here we go. Magmus also stunning in, and the money shot on top of that will set up an easy kill onto Soul Studio. So whenever a team can do that to you, you know, you got to be frustrated and not looking to be in too friendly of a spot as Magmus, he kind of almost traps himself right there. As he's using this lava surge to try to get away from the initiation. The tower is going to be denied, perhaps. A good use of the vulnerability. Excellent job by Malakin. He also ports it on top of Flint Peacewood as well. Great combination right there. He gets the ultimate off, fearing Flint Peacewood a little bit. But Flint Beastwood should be able to buy the distance. Magmus comes in. Oh, Malakin might be in trouble now. Slither, though, spamming those wards. And that's going to be enough to scare them off. Malakin falling back. Not out of the woods just yet, though. Bubbles and Hellbringer are back here. But they're not going to be able to catch up to Malakin, I don't think so. However, they might go for Slither. Nope, they're just going to go to the creep wave and be fine with that. But how about this? Online Kingdom, or this is going to be tough. KD Gaming, they're in this Hellborn side in a very good spot right now. They're taking advantage of their very early game aggressive team.
Oh, definitely. Just the movement and the support, the TPs, everything just going so well together with for KD Gaming. This Hellbringer obviously doing a very impressive job. Seems like just about every time his ultimate is up, he's going to be ganking or pushing one of the lane. While the teamwork is just not quite there for OK Gaming, it seems. So they're spread out, they're not helping each other out when they need to be. And, I mean, their farm is really suffering. I mean, their farm isn't suffering, I would say, just they're about the same where they have been, whereas the other team is just gaining and gaining. Flint's up a bunch of gold as well as, I mean... Yeah, just the whole team, the pushing and the experience lead and goal lead are growing.
Well, yeah, I think the best way to, you know, kind of reflect and to give you evidence of what you're suggesting is the 5 deaths already on Malakin and 3 deaths on Solstice there. By the way, we have initiation down here. Semiju gets initiated on the money shot on top of it. Not enough for the kill, though, as Bubbles trying to tank enough damage. He's going to be fine. There's that Hellbringer ultimate on top of the Pebbles combo, and they make sure to pick up the kill on a Witch Slayer. Slither eventually going down as well. Malakin ports in. He has his ultimate. He's going to use it right there. He's trying to be tanky enough with that lifesteal. Not going to be enough, though. Solstice in here. He has his ultimate. Only 27 souls. Though is going to even try to use it right. He's just throwing out some demon hands, getting as much damage as possible. But the chase is on. Pebbles with the stalagmites and a hat trick coming out for a low QLP. What a fight right there! Andromeda still being chased, and he's going to go down a genocide for KD Gaming. And they did not lose a single player. They are also going to take out the tower right here. KD Gaming in a very, very, very good spot right now. They're executing their strategy like they should, being up 22-7 in hero kills, playing all out aggressive. And again, going into that fight, like I said, we're now looking at 10 deaths between both Malekith and Soulstealer, two heroes that no doubt need to get a very consistent and overall great farm for Online Kingdom, but KD Gaming keeping them locked out the best that they can right now.
Absolutely. Once again, great Hellbringer out there. Just their team. I mean, I noticed that. Okay, their team was just so spread out there that they weren't really focusing anyone down in particular, and they just ended up getting genocided because of it.
So,
see Pebbles as his portal key.
Yeah, that's just made things even that much more dangerous, of course. And in fact, he's going to use it right here. Going, ooh, that's a bad spot though. Online Kingdom doing a good job now of, you know, they're kind of at that point where they got to keep the babysit heroes nearby Soulstealer especially, and that happened to be the case right there. So Pebbles ported in expecting to get a gank on, free gank on Soulstealer like he has been several times this game, but that time Andromeda and Witchslayer right there ready to counter that. Magma's doing some counter warding. Andromeda spots him though, gonna actually stun him. Got the kill though, and then he disjointed the stun with the steam bath, and now he ports out with his lava surge. So well played right there from Magmus. Cardinal, though, I mean, it's are you pretty impressed by KD Gaming's play right now, or do you think it's just mistakes from Online Kingdom?
No, I think it's a combination of, you know, they're playing really well together. They have really good heroes. I think they outpicked OK, in my opinion. They have so much AoE, so much range, so much instant burst that, like, for OK to have a good team fight, they really have to, you know, be out of position. It's gonna be really hard for them to win this game, in my opinion.
Well, okay. With that said, kind of staying on that same trail, I mean, I'm trying to think to myself of, again, Online Kingdom, they're still in a solid spot as far as I'm concerned. You look at Malekith and Soulstealer's farm, despite all of those deaths, the combined 10 deaths total, both of them are still managing a sustainable farm. Malekith, in fact, he's getting very close to finishing his Shrunken Head. You were talking about an item like that earlier being very powerful in this game. Soulstealer, he's still sitting on the Mighty Blade, but of course, you got to figure what the type of farm that he can get. We'll have it in the next 3 or 4 minutes or so. Meanwhile, the top tower push coming in right here by the Hellborn team. They port out immediately after to defend this middle tower. Just the timing is perfect right now for KD Gaming. It's not going to be in deny range as well, so they're going to keep it just out of deny range. At the bottom lane, though, this tower being pushed, so tower pushing all over the place. Dropping a half-life now. Of course, they just used their homecoming stones, but Malekith needs to be careful. He's taking a lot of tower damage right there, and you see the Hellborn players are starting to come over. Hellbringer, Magmus, Slither Ward spots them, however. Good job by Slither using those wards. A tower eventually denied by Flint Beastwood, and well, that's going to take care of that. Now can the Legion team get this middle tower? They forced a lot of those players to move to the bottom, but you saw KD Gaming. They did not overreact right there. Easily, all five could have gone down, you know, overreacted, but they had at least two players stay middle, and they denied the middle tower as well. So again, just very heads up, smart play from KD Gaming. But okay, so now back to my point though, Cardinal. Malekith, he's gonna have his Shrunken Head possibly now very soon. Soulstealer, same deal. Once they get those Shrunken Heads, do you think we should expect to see a bit of a change in play, and, you know, a change in pace perhaps?
I mean, it could happen, but you gotta think, even though they have Shrunken Head, like, Hellbringer is gonna rock them when they see him, you know, start to hold or start to initiate, and even Magnus can initiate on Soulstealer or Malekith before he even pops his Shrunken Head. So, I mean, it could happen. It's just going to have to go much later, and they're going to have to, you know, start team fighting, possibly try and delay a Kongor, because if they get Kongor, it's going to be really tough.
Well, we'll see. Once they eventually do get those Shrunken Heads, of course. But, yeah, like you said, as it always seems to be, Kongor is definitely a huge issue. Huge issue. And right now, I think it's safe to say KD Gaming has every advantage to do that right now. On top of being Hellborn, they also have the push going on in their favor. As we do look at the tower kills, well, actually, I guess shouldn't say that, because technically we're actually tied at three tower kills apiece. Although two of them were denied by the Hellborn team, they still are down, of course. Next step, you'd have to look at wards. Right now, KD Gaming, a couple of very aggressive place wards on the side of Legion River, whereas the Legion team, that's a Slither ward. There we go. That's their ward of sight on their side of the river. So right now, I mean, it is safe to say, I think, that KD Gaming has the map position and map pressure, because not only because of the ward control, but because of just the aggressive nature of their team. But Fallen Kingdom, they are doing a solid job themselves. And speaking of the Shrunken Heads, by the way, both Malakin and Soul Sealer have finished them as expected around this time. So now we'll get more of an idea of what to overall expect. Sheepstick being worked on Hellbringer, by the way, it looks like, because he's got that Blessed Orb and Mana Tube. Pebbles, he picks up Plate Mail. In this case, my first reaction would be Frost Field, but Demonic would be beneficial to obviously Flint Pieced as well as Legion Team. They do have a couple of minus armor effects between Andromeda and Soul Stealer, so either or, wouldn't be surprised. Soul Stealer.
Demonic.
Go ahead.
Shiva's isn't that good on Pebbles, in my opinion.
So you'd prefer Demonic Breastplate then for this case?
Oh yeah, I mean, Pebbles is hitting for 180, and with the increased attack speed and the minus armor and his gained armor, he might be able to, like, take Soul Stealer on even if he has BKB on.
Alright, yeah, either one. It seems like we always talk about it. Either one definitely has its benefits. Just seems to come down to, you know, maybe the game and the setup, but yeah, on this guy I could see either one, but a Demonic Breastplate would be very, very, very powerful. Top of the reasons that you suggested. Pebbles was roaming around right there, by the way. Thankfully, he did not run right next to this Word of Revelation. Wasn't spotted, I don't believe, with the Invis Rune. He might have got caught out himself, but he just used it for scouting purposes. Malakin, by the way, going the what we usually see build on him. Shrunken Head, Whispering Helm combo. He's got the Hungry Spirit now, so of course we'll eventually... Wouldn't think Elder Parasite. Would think Whispering Helm. Magmus, his portal key is... He just had enough gold to buy it, so well, there we go. He's going to have his portal key now. That's a good pickup. Around the 27-minute mark or so. Not too shabby. Another valid option.
Definitely, just with the initiation that they already have on their team. Hellbringer ult goes down, Bubble ult goes down. Magmus comes in. It's going to be really hard. I mean, obviously those Shrunken Heads are going to be huge in that fight. But all their support's probably going to get taken out, so really interesting to see the next team fight that comes up.
So there again, he's been doing an excellent job of just really spreading those wards. This has been more and more of a popular Slither build, by the way, Helm of the Black Legion. Again, I keep referring to Trixie. I know it sounds like I'm just riding on him. He is a great player, but he does. He definitely shows us more of these different heroes with these awesome builds, so... that's why you just kind of have to refer back to him, but at least recently I've been playing Slither like this, spending a lot of time in the jungle just spamming those wards, and it has proven to work out effectively. Also, picking up something like an eye eventually to counter ward effectively is definitely a popular idea as well. We will see. Hellborn team, they're grouping up against Congor here, though. They kind of want to do it, but just want to make sure that everything is good around. They're going to go for it now. Legion team, though, they have somewhat of an idea, and there we go. The Aurora comes out. And actually, it did not hit Congo. I don't know if the Hellborn team even saw it, actually. I don't even know if it went all the way, and whether or not the Legion team even saw them doing it. They have pings over there. It's taking a long time to kill this Congo, so Legion team has a lot of time to group up here and make their initiation happen. Pebble's hanging off to the side. He is ready to counter if need be. Slither Ward's going out. There goes Malakin jumping in. He activates the ultimate. Wait for the Hellbringer ultimate now to come out any second. There we go on the midst of the pack, and here we go with chaos ensuing. Slither's ultimate exploding. Hellbringer's going to eventually fall down. Magma sitting in that steam bath. Soul Stealer trying to clean up the best he can after activating his ultimate, and it looks like Online Kingdom maybe winning this fight. Can they pick off Flint Beastwood right here? Malakin trying to stay in range. Yes, he can. He gets a kill on Flint Beastwood, and Magmus and Pebbles both, Pebbles, he's still hanging around somewhat, but he needs to think about getting out of there. Magmus, on the other hand, he is going to try to port out. He looks like he will be fine. Now the question is, can Online Kingdom ninja this Congor? I don't know. They don't have the greatest lifeblood, at least Malakin and Witchslayer. You know, it's so tempting right now, but you do got to be very, very careful. Even though you have three players down, you do not want Pebbles to jump in there out of nowhere and just drop you. So they're going to play it safe and actually just sit back and farm once again.
Yeah, I think it was definitely a successful stand by OK Gaming there. They didn't lose Soul Stealer or Malakin, so I think it was a 2-for-3 exchange. So this is definitely a successful fight for them. I was very surprised. I think it was just lack of communication or initiation there by KD Gaming. as soon as Malkin came in, he obviously put on his shrunken head, and I saw Magnus jump right on top of him with the ultimate. I'm like, well, that's not really doing anything. And they were really just spread out throughout the whole fight, and OK was just able to pick him up.
Yay. That's what happens when we have a Pebbles get the farm like he has and going against the support players. Expected to happen several more times this game against both Witch Slayer and Andromeda for that matter. Oh, look at this. Hellborn, they're going to go where they left off. They do not have Flint Beastwood with them just yet. He's coming over right now. But again, they don't have the greatest damage. I mean, they are relying a lot on magical. And obviously, Kongar received a buff lately to... I believe it's something like 75% less magic damage taken or something like that. So he's still dropping fairly slow. Legion team spots it again. They have the ward out there. Pebbles, though, jumps on them first this time. Great counter initiated from the Hellborn team. Malakin gets annihilated. Slither gets his ultimate off, but now he's trying to get away. Oh, great placement of that Soul Steeler ultimate. That's going to do a lot of damage. Flint Beastwood goes down. Hellbringer goes down. This is going to be huge right here. Can they also pick off Magmus possibly? Slither did end up getting taken out as well. Magmus, though, using the Lava Surge on the high ground. Swap incoming. No, he cannot stay in range. What a port from Magmus just before the Demon Hand. And Bubbles is going to get away as well. But we could very likely finally see Conqueror be going down here. Hellborn team, though, they have every knowledge of them possibly doing that. Bubbles, will they go for the Ninja now is the question. Here we go. He's going to go with the Turtle Shell. He ports in. Oh, but the combo on his Soul Steel. But what a swap from Andromeda. Prevented maximum damage. Pebbles now dropping. And Pebbles will be going down as well. Conqueror is still barely alive. This is unbelievable. It's been about a 5-minute overall action sequence at Conqueror right here. Will he finally get out? No, he won't. Magmus jumps in. Takes out Witch Slayer. Bubbles now also in here. They're going to ninja the token of life on Bubbles. And Soul Steeler will be going down as well. He can knock it off that last Demon Hand. And KD Gaming, in the end, are going to come out with a token of life. What a freaking fight right there. Unbelievable. Just back and forth. And KD Gaming, they were the ones that initially went in 5 minutes ago or so. And they finally come out on top with the token.
Yeah, what a sequence there. I really think KD should have... should have had the presence of mind to note that Magmus is up. He hadn't used his ultimate in the fight before, and coming in on low heroes, low HP heroes like that is just going to clean him right up. I think they should have backed off after the initial things going their way. They're just stuck around a little too long on the Hellborn side there.
What about you, Cardinal? Anything you want to point out about that fight?
Yeah, that was... I don't know. I just have a hard time going into Kongor, like, when all five heroes are up. You know, the first time they went in, they brought it down to half, and then there was a team fight, and OK won that one. And then OK went back when they had, like, three. And then KD just kept going in and spamming them, knowing that it's not going to go down as fast as still early, and ended up winning that fight and getting the Aegis, so... Definitely, OK had the advantage, and then they went back in. I think that's probably what happened. That's the reason why they lost that fight. They should have just kept farming and taking that advantage, because the gold lead was only like 3,000 at that point.
I think another big thing about that fight as well, ultimately what helped KD Gaming lead to their Token of Life pickup and the victory overall on the team fight was they initiated first. By the way, we have a big time initiation here, locking down Hellbringer. He gets the ultimate off, though. He tanks it long enough. Malakin activates a shrunken head. The Pebbles combination also ports in, but Pebbles is dropping fast. He's going to eventually go down. Soulstealer, they're joining the party, so that's going to force off the Hellborn team. Malakin tanking as much damage again. Magmus comes in with a Lava Surge, ultimate combination, and that's enough for a kill right there onto Malakin. Now chasing back to Soulstealer. He still has a Shrunken Head activated. He avoids the damage from that Turtle Shell. As a result, it might buy him enough time. Yes, he Portal Keys out. He's going to live, but Slither, oh, the Helm of the Black Legion keeps him alive. He avoids the Flare. Not going to matter, though. Magmus with a Lava Surge to finish him off, and they're going to fall back. Wow, Hellborn team again turning that around. Legion team initiated first, but Andromeda swap in there kind of confused them a little bit. Hellbringer able to get his ultimate off before he finally ended up dying was huge once again. And it just seems like KD Gaming seeming to barely come out in some of these team fights, but they are coming out on top. And as a result, we now have a 35-16 hero kill advantage in favor of KD Gaming. And Fluxy on Flint Beastwood His farm has progressively been getting better and better all throughout this game. He is now up to 315 gold per minute, and he already has his Geometer's Bane. So better and better news constantly for KD Gaming. It seems like still having the Token of Life on Bubbles, that's another big thing. Maybe not the ideal hero to have it on, but obviously in the situation they were occurring, that was occurring, they didn't really have too much time to sit there and think about it, just had to grab it, but still can use it effectively. And Hellbringer, he's he's about halfway there to finishing his Sheep Stick, just needs the Acolyte Staff. So more and more items getting picked up on this Hellborn team. You keep looking through the Legion side. Most of their heroes seem to be sitting on the same, if not really too impressive, items. Portal Key picked up on Soulstealer, of course. He's had that for a little bit now. Malakin finishing his Whispering Helm. But compared to the Hellborn team, definitely, once again, like them a little bit more in that case.
Definitely. It's just every team fight, it seems like KD's coming out a little bit ahead, and these advantages are really starting to stack up. You see 11,000 experience, about 8,000 gold, and one thing I really wanted to point out is the Magmus ults the last couple fights have been really superb. It's, he didn't come in right away, but he waited and he got right on top of Soulstealer and pretty much decimated Malakin. I think he learned his lesson and realized that, well, they're going to have their shrunken heads on at the beginning of the fight, so if I come in a little bit later, I'm really going to hurt them, and definitely happened there.
Yeah, that's obviously a really good point. Of course, if he goes in with the Shrunken Head, doesn't do nearly as much damage, or doesn't do any damage, frankly, to Soulstealer and Malakin, for that matter, if they have those activated. Slither, by the way, it's actually put a thought in my mind, too. Barrier Idol, as it always is, against someone like a Magmus, but even just all around this Hellborn team, they're relying on a good amount of magic damage, so Barrier Idol, I think, would be huge in this game. Pebbles, by the way, he gets swapped. He's going to be dropping fast right here, and there he goes. Slither, though, jumps in, gets an ultimate off as well, and you see both Shrunken Heads being used. Hellborn ultimate still going through. The Shrunken Head's now off. There's a Bubble ultimate keeping them in place. Can they make something happen here? Magmus coming in. He does not have his ultimate activated, but using the Steam Bath right on top of them after the Lava Surge, and yes, it's going to be enough overall damage. Just too much AoE damage here from KD Gaming after the Shrunken Heads are deactivated. Slither is going to port out. Looks like he's going to be fine. But here goes a defensive tower now, and invulnerability used right away. But very likely going to be taken out here by KD Gaming. And just not much Online Kingdom can do, only with Slither. Oh, what a graveyard stone by Witchslayer right there. The combination on a Magmus as well. And he gets a ninja kill and then runs away. So at least it got something out of it. You see Smack not too happy about that, but they got the tower kill, and they get out. So it seems like even if Online Kingdom, they've done a solid job of initiating, especially with those swaps, but KD Gaming, they group up and showing that their team fight is just a little bit too much more powerful, and it's going to Online Kingdom, they need Malakin to get crazy carry status and Soulstealer as well. It looks like at this point, at least, if they want to have a chance of winning this game, because right now these team fights are not working well for them whatsoever. And Flint Beastwood, his farm continues to grow, and in fact he has taken over as the top farmer in the game right now at 340 gold per minute.
Yeah, right there, just the superior team presence really showing through. Even though Magnus didn't get a very good hold off that time, almost did no damage to both the Shrunken-Headed players. But at the end, I think it was really quite a bungle by Magix and Black, both walking out of the bubbles ult and getting stunned at exactly the same time, right next to each other. Magmus has a great surge in, stuns them both, and they just fall from there.
Yeah, Magmus and Witchslayer stuns, obviously, work pretty much like each other. It's always fun to watch those line up. Players just fly in the air. Slither has picked up a Shaman's Headdress, so again, I would likely think that he's going to turn that into a Barrier Idol. I can't stress enough how huge that would be here for Online Kingdom, and they can definitely take advantage of it. Demonic Breastplate is being worked on by Pebbles, by the way. He did have a Warp Cleft on the Courier, at least. Swap here on a Magmus as he's doing some warding, actually. Unfortunately, he's warding on top of another ward, but great play once again. He ports out before the damage is done to him and gets out of there. Smack is playing an awesome, awesome Magmus. It seems like we keep referring back to him, especially in those team fights and just awesome getaways like that. So deserves a lot of credit in this game so far for KD Gaming. Formerly known as Dirty Minds, going up against Online Kingdom. Formerly known as KD Gaming. Yes, it's confusing. Congo or Bubbles, does he still have the token? Oh my god, he does. He still has 2 minutes left on the token. I completely forgot about that, but he still has it, and he's yet to die with it. I mean, Cardinal, do you think that KD Gaming should look to play aggressive here because of that? You know, they have been playing aggressive, but should they look to, you know, go for an all-out push because they have that token of life? Or is it smart to just play safe, and if it wears out, then it wears out?
Well, they can't really push much against Slither, because if they just send out an all-out push, Slither's just going to ult, and then, you know, Malakin and Soulstealer are just going to go in with their BKBs and just shred them. I think that with their portal keys, and it looks like they have a sheep stick and maybe a couple more sheep sticks on the way, they could just keep putting pressure by ganking and then take advantage of like a 3v5 or a 4v5 fight and then just push at those points, or even Kongor when it's up.
Speaking of Sheepstick, I'll bring it up here as you were referring to. Another good swap just at the last second on the Witch Slayer, but not going to be able to have him survive. But here we go. That was a huge Soulstealer ultimate, turning it around completely. Hellbringer goes down. Bubbles finally comes in. We have two players down for the Legion side. Soulstealer trying to stay alive. He nukes down Magnus right there, as well as getting the kill on Bubbles. He's going to resurrect, of course, but Malakin holding his ground. Now Bubbles needs to somehow get out of here. Using the takeover as a portal in 1 second, he will be successful. The Lucian Star are going to drop, and Flint Beastwood actually didn't seem to be involved too much in that team fight. He's got out of there pretty early and didn't do too much damage himself. Malphus gets taken out, and Bubble still trying to make his getaway. There he goes with the portal key. Gets his juke on. Slither spots him perfectly, though. The turtle shell, is he going to pour? Yes, he is. And it looks like he's finally going to get away, but for the first time, it seems like the Legion team has won a team fight here in this game. That's great news for them. Like I said, though, I don't believe Flint Beastwood was there for really most of that fight, and that definitely possibly hurt them. But ultimately, what it really did, I really think, was the Soulstealer ultimate. It was perfect placement. He got three heroes really close to him, clumped up, and it did a lot of damage. So Soulstealer also surviving in the end, and he takes the money that he just got to help him finish that Geometer's Bane. So, as we were talking about, Online Kingdom at this point, it's just about getting Malakin and Soulstealer. They're too beefy to the point where they just take over. And that definitely helped, but KD Gaming still a slight advantage at this point.
Definitely, it's fights like that that can really start to turn things around. You see Malakin picking up a Warp Cleft, going for Demonic, and Soulstealer finishing his Geometer's Bane, so they're definitely not out of it by any means. I think the problem with that fight was there is where they chose to fight it is here, down on the Legion side, south of Concord. There's kind of like a choke point where the Legion team was fighting on high ground and they were on the low ground, and Flint was not able to position himself very well to deal maximum DPS. And I mean, as long as Malakin and Soulstealer survive, they're in a pretty good position to win the rest of the fight.
So Congress back up. Now that we all remember the fun little action sequence we had last time, about 5 minutes worth of it overall. We'll see if possibly have something like that again. Hellborn team, they are hanging out around that area. Maybe seeing if the Legion team will bite on it, but they're not going in there. They're kind of hanging around the middle area themselves. Malakin, he's been sitting with this Warp Cleft. I would think Demonic Breastplate, with that said. But we'll see. So technically, I guess you can kind of say the Demonic Breastplates will cancel out each other, at least as a group from the aura effects. But smart pickup nonetheless. Barrier Rattle being worked on, so yeah, he got the Refreshing Ornament. Now he just needs the money for the recipe on Semiju playing Slither. He'll have that shortly. He needs 1,000 gold. He has around 800 gold saved up. Again, will be very, very big. Flint Beastwood, he's finished that Geometer's like we were talking about earlier, and he's very close to getting his Frostwolf Skull. That's going to be dangerous. Very effective, especially against that Malakin. The attack speed slow. That's obviously what Malakin relies on to keep himself alive a lot of the time, between his talent, the Hellborn Zeal, as well as his attack speed from his items. A lot of pinging going on. So, we're kind of at that stalemate phase where, obviously, with Conqueror just resurrecting, both teams, they want to do it, but neither one wants to play the overall initiator, and for very good reason, of course. I mean, both teams are nearby, so to kind of put yourself in a clumped-up spot like that would be dangerous. But at the same time, you know, the Hellborn team, it's both teams. They definitely have a good clump-up AoE damage, I guess. Hellborn team maybe a little bit more, but if they do clump themselves up and the Legion team jumps in like we saw last team fight, then Legion team by all means can do a lot of damage themselves. So yeah, it's just such a dangerous spot. But oh my god, here we go. Hellborn team, they are going in right here. They're going on a Kongor. They have Ward of Sight, so they'll be able to speed them. They'll be able to spot them, of course. Here we go with this one. Will the Legion team, you know, kind of show themselves before? Oh, they're still doing it. Kongor not dropping fast, though. They do not have enough damage. Magmus activated the ultimate. They're going to go in now. That was a bait right there from the Hellborn team. The Magmus ultimate activated. Andromeda's going to drop. Slither also caught right here. He's trying to get a good placement for his ultimate. He gets it off. Hellbringer dropping fast. Will he go down? He is still somewhat alive. Oh, but he gets chucked back into the team fight. But he is still alive, actually. The power supply enough to keep him alive. And look at this. Soulstealer is just running away. What can he do? He ports out of there, but he obviously did everything he could already, and now he's just trying to play the survive game, prevent the genocide. But KD Gaming, they're not going to let that go easy, and they catch Soulstealer right there with the Lava Surge, and the money shot from Fluxy to finish him off. Genocide for KD Gaming. What superb play right there. That was a pure bait on the Kongor. They got Online Kingdom to position themselves where they want it, and then KD Gaming opened on Online Kingdom. Surprisingly enough, though, they're not going straight for that Kongor kill. They're actually going to go for this push first. They want to be able to take out the tower as well as the racks, and then maybe fall back and finish off Kongor. We will see, but this is going to be an interesting move. But Soulstealer will be down for another 50 seconds. Malakin down for another 30, so I believe they should have enough time. Pebbles ports in. He actually, Witch Slayer also ported away just before he could do anything. As all this Witch Slayer silver bullet to take out Pebbles. That's got to be frustrating for him. He was just low enough to go down, but they'll at least get the melee racks. And you got to figure that they're going to fall back, maybe go for Kongor at this point. Witch Slayer comes in, though, going to keep them distracted. There's a swap onto somebody as well. I believe it was Magnus that he ports out. And I don't know. I don't think KD Gaming is actually going to be able to do an effective Kongor right here without being a little bit scared. So, and then they're not going to head to it. And so choosing to go for the melee racks instead of the Kongor, what do you guys think about that?
I think that was a good idea. I mean, they showed last time they can bait Kongor pretty well. Being Hellborn, taking it out is not going to be too difficult, but I think Arax is definitely worth it in this case.
Yeah, I agree. Taking out Arax mid, you got to remember the creeps give less gold, and in the long run it could work out better, because they have the advantage in Hellborn and Kongor, so they can do it anytime they pick off, you know, Witch Slayer or Andro. With their heroes, it's probably the best idea.
Well, that they did, and so at least I'll say this much. It at least is going to provide for, I'm sure, another entertaining Kongor fight, so that's good. I get a lot of complaints sometimes. I get some complaints sometimes that people say that you talk too much about Kongor. You always say how big it is, and it's games like this that show like why and how big it is. I mean, two major fights now have happened right at this Kongor pit, and maybe even three, and definitely big tide turning fights in this game, because both teams understand how big that Kongor is and how getting that token alive on top of the extra gold you get, and you know, at eventually get those bananas. And this is still only the second one, though, I believe, so it would still be just a token alive. But anyways, yeah. Katie, do you want to say something? Go ahead. Sorry.
No, it was the second one. But yeah, okay. I agree. Kongor is huge, almost as big as runes, but that's pretty big.
Yeah, and again, clearly evident from this game how how much both teams are distressing on trying to at least just sit around this area hoping for the best. I guess we'll look around at items as we are kind of just at a standstill once again. Again, the Legion team, they know what happened last time. Demonic Breastplate finished on Malakin, by the way. Are they going to go in here? Will they get caught again is the question. There goes a swap on Hellbringer. He gets the ultimate off, though. Here we go once again. Magmus stuns in with a great ultimate yet again. Witch Slayer immediately picked off. There goes a Soulstealer jumping into the middle. He takes out Hellbringer. Slither gets off his ultimate as well. Flint Beastwood sitting off here in the background, though, just pussing out DPS. He gets a money shot off. Not enough for the kill, I don't believe, though. And now he needs to fall back as Malakin chasing him. Malakin drop below himself, however, and he starts to fall back. So both teams kind of scattering right there. Numbers advantage in favor of the Legion side. Soulstealer ended up actually getting picked off down here. Now we see the chase is still on to a Slither, and he gets comboed down. So the Hellborn team once again going to win this team fight. We have Malakin. It just falls back to the middle lane. He's just going to take out the creeps, and he's just looking to, you know, fall back now, because it looks like KD Gaming will get the Kongor kill. And they once again will have another token alive. I was actually watching a social illusion there for a while, so I do apologize. I missed the real one actually dying, but he obviously got caught in the jungle trying to run away. So it seems like we're just having a rinse and repeat here. The same thing happens. The Legion team starts to go in. The Hellborn team initiates first, though. Obviously, that, I guess, was technically a Legion initiation with a swap, but it, Hellborn team is right on top of just reacting right away. Conger goes down, and Flint Beastwood picks up that token of life. This could very likely be the beginning of the end here in favor of KD Gaming. I just think OK is just banging their head against the wall one too many times at this point. And it's going to be tough. But Malakin and Solstice there, they still have, they both are pretty well farmed. Flint Beastwood, though, he's pretty dangerous himself. Good little drink there. This has been an awesome game, though. I mean, I don't think I've ever seen a game necessarily where just so much emphasis has been put on a Conqueror. Like, especially after that first fight, that was one of the most entertaining, if not the most entertaining Conqueror fight I've ever seen. And then we've had at least two or three more even since then. So this has just really been a fight for that Conqueror. And with the 49-23 hero kill advantage now, obviously you look at that, you figure KD Gaming is overwhelmingly having the advantage. They've had just a great hero kill advantage throughout this whole game, but because of the lineups and everything, Online Kingdom, they've still been in this game a good chunk of it. Again, though, like I was just suggesting, it really seems like we're kind of getting to that hump, however, where it's just going to be too much to overcome for Online Kingdom. You talked about the Sheepsticks being picked up. Now there's a Sheepstick as well on Magmis. Demonic Breastplate finished on Pebbles. And, of course, we've already referred to Flint Beastwood. So now they're just going to push this bottom lane right here and hope to make the best of this push and try to see what they can make happen.
That fight definitely was pretty crazy.
I definitely think DM's been playing. I'm sorry, KD been playing really well this game. They didn't push their luck too much. They just built up advantages over and over and over again, winning team fights here and there. They lost a couple, but in the end, obviously you can see the stats just too much in their favor, and they're doing a really good job. Probably gonna try to end it now with a couple of Sheepsticks, and just overall, their supports are way more useful.
Yeah, you say a couple more Sheepstick. It kind of sounds funny, but honestly, it could be true. I mean, Bubbles has a Blessed Orb. He could very likely be going for a Sheepstick of his own. And at this point, Pebbles, hell, he could just buy his next item into a Sheepstick. It'll be a while, but, you know, he could. So we could very likely see even up to four Sheepsticks on this team. Oh, no, excuse me, though. Hellflower just finished on Bubbles. I think I actually heard you talking about that, Cardinal. You like that pickup?
No, yeah, I like Sheepstick on Bubbles, but Hellflower is kind of iffy.
Well, ultimately, I mean, the biggest thing about it is, again, the Perplex ability, and stopping a Shrunken Head from happening, I think, is obviously a big part of it. But the overall silence as well, and just the damage done can be useful. It isn't an item we get to see too often, though, so whenever we do see it, I always am a fan of seeing items just because we don't see it too often. I think it has its usefulness, but I can definitely see why at the same time, why other items are preferred.
One thing I want to see in this next team fight is either Witch Slayer or Andromeda bring a Sentry Ward to the fight, because the two heroes that are initiating are Bubbles, Hellbringer, well, Hellbringer just is rock, but Magmus. And Magmus just Steam Bass right after, and if they have a Sentry Ward down, they can maybe pick him off, and that might, you know, turn the fight a little bit, but it might be a little too late for that.
Yeah, exactly. I think you said it best there at the end. It just might be a little bit too late for that. I mean, they've already got the middle lane pushed up as a result of the melee racks being down. Just overall team fight, the numbers advantage is just vastly in their favor at this point. 21,000 gold lead, 25,000 experience lead. And kind of touching back on what you're referring to with initiation as well, Andromeda, it seems like this Legion team has been relying a lot on Andromeda swapping to initiate. I don't know if I can necessarily agree with that in the long run, the more you think about it. Because, obviously, with that swap, she's pretty much saying, I'm just going to suicide. There's no way she's going to live after a swap, and we've pretty much been seeing that over and over and over again. The second she swaps, she puts herself in an awful spot, and the Hellborn team reacts to that right away. So if she gets taken out, you know, she may not even get her Aurora off, you know, on top of that, as well as the Dimensional Link. It's, although it's only level 2, it still is something, and it obviously scales very, very well going into the later game. We do have initiation, though, from the Hellborn team, and there's a swap, though, on a Solstice. They're kind of helping him a little bit, trying to make it so he can have something happen here, but just too many ultimates from the Hellborn team combining two. While Malakin is standing his ground, however, he's going to look to take out Bubbles right here. Good take cover right there by some time, but the sword throw will finish him off. You see Flint Beastwood, however, through all of that, he was just tanking all that damage. He still has his token alive. He gets the kill on Slither, and Malakin is like, guys, I tried. He's going to keep going back in here, throwing his random sword. Ooh, Magnus sitting fairly low. But he's in the steam bath where it's safe and cozy. So the ranged barracks will be going down right here. And I think we're kind of getting to that point where we can start to say KD Gaming, they're going to take a 1-0 series lead here. Again, a best out of 3 series here in the winner's bracket quarterfinals. But KD Gaming, formerly known as Dirty Minds, on their way to taking game 1. And that's a good combo to finish it off right there. A nice genocide to complete it as a... Magmus and Flint Beastwood combo him down. Flint Beastwood sitting very low on life. He's actually just going to, almost let the tower take him down, but again, he has a token of life. Dodges the Aurora, actually, which would have killed him probably. And he's just like, well, you know what? I'm just about dead, but I'll resurrect. Who cares? Pebbles get swapped. That's, he ports out just in time, though. And we still make a god, however. Yes, he does. As, oh my god, Fluxy just took out Andromeda, however, with, again, 100 life or so. He just stood his ground. Takes out the melee racks. And expect to see that GG concede fairly shortly. In fact, there we go. There's a concede, and there's a GG. So, KD Gaming takes game 1. Very, very fun game. Glad that we casted it. But that is just the beginning of the series, guys. We have game 2 coming up next. Final thoughts, though, on game 1 there, Brent.
Excellent team play by DM throughout the whole game. Really sticking together. Being very mobile in the early game. Keeping... Malakin and the Soul Stealer from really taking off, and in the end, their overall team play and the heroes they picked were really good. So definitely give them props for that game.
Very impressive indeed, and I think you said, I mean, again, it's KD Gaming, they just played superb that game. They did not rely on a bunch of mistakes. They just played fast and really, really, really solid game. Cardinal, you have any comments to make before you move into game 2 here?
Yeah, I think, although besides the fact that I think Hellborn outpicked Legion, they really played really well. Like they used their heroes the way they should. Like Pebbles ganked Soulstealer early, he needed to keep him down. I mean, you can't really stop Soulstealer from getting items eventually, but if you can delay it as much as possible, it's going to give you a really good chance to win. And I'd like to see Legion pick an initiator next game, because, you know, Slither's a good hero, but if with a good initiator, like, they could have won that game, I think.
Yeah, I agree with you 100%. Like I said, like I started to get into that point, they were relying really on Andromeda swaps as their initiation tool, and that it really... basically says we're just going to make it a 4v4. We'll get a hero that we want to be able to pick up, but even then, you know, we saw so many times on the Hellbringer, they swapped him initially, but he still got the ultimate off, and as long as he gets the ultimate off, he basically had his effective use on top of the life point. On top of that, I mean, just a lot of damage coming out. So, KD Gaming, though, again, very deserving, and they take game 1. That's just game 1, though, guys. Again, a best out of 3 series, and even if you lose here, you're still in the loser's bracket. So, still in it, but, of course, both teams trying to play to get to the semifinals here in the winner's bracket, where they'll be in prime position to at least guarantee themselves $2,000 here from the Ghost Gamers main event. So... Oh, sorry, I wasn't holding down my vent. I was talking, but I wasn't talking to you guys. Anyways, that's going to do it. So game 2 coming up next. Stay tuned. As for this game 1, we are done. Again, let's break your CPK. Joining me was Brent Quest of Honcast, as well as Cardinal from SK Gaming. Game 2 coming up next. Stay tuned.
Henry D.
Yo, Cardinal.